Hi Richard, have you heard about GM crops, the modern plant biotechnology?
Yes, of course. Biotech crop adoption surges as economic benefits. Since 1996, 67 countries have adopted biotech crops involving 17 million farmers.
Oh really? I didn't know that. What do you mean by economic benefits?
Crops yield has increased by 112-fold in 22 years. Biotechnology contributed a lot by increasing crop productivity for food security. It also helping alleviate poverty and hunger, where biotech crops has uplifted the lives of millions of small farmers.
Huh.
Not only that, modern plant biotechnology also contributed for a greater sustainability by conserving biodiversity and providing a better environment. Less pesticide and herbicide applications decreased environmental impact. GM crops grown on 2.3 billion hectares also reducing carbon dioxide emission. So, what do you think, Anna?
Yes, I got the idea now. I am wondering how GM crops can contribute that much.
Because GM crops have been genetically improved. The most prominent examples include genes that make the crops resistant to insects, viruses and herbicides. The first GM characteristic to be widely adopted was resistance to a herbicide called Roundup, or glyphosate, in soybeans. Resistance to these types of broad herbicide, which would usually kill both weeds and crops, means that efficient weed control is possible because the herbicide can be applied while the crop is growing, without damaging the crop. Without herbicide-tolerant crops, a range of different types of herbicides might be needed to clear out all the weeds before planting the crop. Another benefit of herbicide-tolerant crops is that they can be planted into a weedy field, because the weeds can be controlled with herbicide. This reduces the need for plowing, which means less soil erosion.
I see. How about insect and viruses resistance?
The bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis, BT, produces a group of proteins known as the BT toxin, which are toxic for certain insects, but do not harm beneficial insects or other animals. BT is used as an insecticide spray in organic farming. Genes for several BT toxins have been introduced into many crops by grams. For example, over 90% of the cotton planted in the USA, India, China, Australia and South Africa are GM varieties containing BT toxin genes. Over the last 20 years, it is estimated that the application of 450,000 tons of insecticide has been avoided due to the use of BT toxin genes in crops. GM has been used to resurrect the papaya industry of Hawaii, as papaya ring spot virus almost destroyed its plantations in the 1990s. There are no known papaya varieties with natural resistance to this virus, but by adding a gene to the papaya from the virus itself, resistant papaya strains were created. Today 77% of Hawaiian papaya farmers grow GM papaya.
Is it safe to consume GM crop? I mean, you never know the effects of foreign genes. That bits of DNA are not naturally found in normal plants. I am worried if they can cause allergic reactions or other unknown diseases.
There is no evidence that a crop is dangerous to eat just because it is GM. There could be risks associated with the specific new gene introduced, which is why each crop with a new characteristic introduced by GM is subject to close scrutiny. Since the first widespread commercialization of GM produce 18 years ago, there has been no evidence of negative effects linked to the consumption of any approved GM crop. Before any food produced using GM technology is permitted onto the market, a variety of tests have to be completed. The results from these tests, including results from animal feeding trials, are considered by the authorities responsible for determining the safety of each new GM product. This makes new GM crop varieties at least as safe to eat as new non-GM varieties, which are not tested in this way.
Thank you, Richard, for your explanation. Hope to bump into you again.
My pleasure, Anna. Take care.